I'm Ken Holscher. I'm an associate professor and also an extension entomologist in the Department of Entomology at Iowa State University. Well, there's an awful lot of interest in the bedbug world from the general public, both here in Iowa and across the country. A lot of the calls I received were from the standpoint of, well, we're going to be traveling, we're going to be staying in hotels, we're going to be staying in other people's or other folks' homes. What can we do to prevent dragging bedbugs home with us if, in fact, those hotels or those houses have them? Number one, don't leave your suitcase on the floor, especially not next to your bed. When you're not using your suitcase, make sure it's all zipped up nice and tight. We would urge people, say in hotels, to at the very least place that suitcase on that little fold-out stand that most hotels have. If they don't have that fold-out stand, place them on top of the dresser. And probably, you know, some people tell me that what they do is actually take their suitcase when they're not using it and put it in a bathtub. Other folks tell me that they carry a big old black trash bags with them, and that when they're not using their suitcase, especially at night, they will actually place it in a trash bag and then seal that up. I'm not too concerned about clothes that you hang on the rod. They're not going to get into those. But many folks that I know, if they're going to be staying in a hotel for more than a day, will actually unpack their suitcase and place their clothes into the dresser drawers. I would urge you not to do that. The reason for that is if there are bed bugs that may be hiding in the drawers, they could crawl between, you know, the folds of the clothes. And so when you repack your suitcase, you really don't shake anything out. You just grab your clothes and place them in the suitcase. Bed bugs leave a characteristic type of a bite. They're going to feed on the first piece of exposed skin that they come to. So chances are you're going to find bites along the shoulders, the arms, the neck. Over the years, I've worked with a lot of residents in terms of their insect ticker mite problems, and as a general rule, what I try to do is if I think they're capable of doing it, I try to work with the homeowners to solve their own problem. It's usually less expensive to do that than to hire that done. But there are certain things that I've just come to realize that probably are better left to the professionals, simply because of the materials that they use, their experience, and this is one. My advice is don't jump to conclusions. Make sure you have a problem before you go to the extent and expense of having someone come in and do a treatment of any type.